With the changes from the CARES Act regarding charitable contributions, the additional benefits you could get this year, should you be setting up a donor-advised fund? Gosh, with the run-up in the stock market, is now the time to be setting up a donor-advised fund? I'll tell you why, what it is, and if you should consider it coming up. Hey, my name is Mike Bernard. I'm the host of The Wise Money Show. I'm also one of the certified financial planners right here at Corehorn Financial Group. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, and smash that thumbs up button. Okay, the stock market's had just an incredible run this year after a devastating loss in the first quarter. And now we're still grappling with the market being at these levels and yet some really unique tax planning strategies. You're probably aware of something called a donor advised fund, And now this year, 2020, given the unique circumstances we find ourselves in with the stock market being where it is, with future volatility still very much possible and a lot of uncertainty out there and some unique tax benefits, now might be the time for you to consider a donor advised fund. So what is it? You know how an HSA, health savings account, you create an account, you can set money aside into that HSA as long as you're eligible. And when you do that, you get a tax benefit. And then you've got this money sitting in this account. And then as you need to use it for medical expenses, you have a debit card or whatever, you just use that money for your medical expenses. So it's almost like a savings account that's set aside just for medical expenses, and there's a tax benefit to it. It's the same, a donor advised fund is the same type of idea. It's a giving fund. You set up an account, typically an investment account, and you set it up and you can make a donation directly into that giving account. And when you make that donation into that account, that's when it gets written off on your tax return. And then you choose when and how, for the most part, you choose when and how you disperse the money from that giving account, from that donor advised fund, to the charity of your choice, right? You can set up the donor advised fund when you make the contribution into it, when you make the donation into the fund. That's when it helps you on your taxes. So you can do that this year. You'll get a write-off this year, but then you can choose to disperse that money from the donor advised fund to the 501c3 of your choice at the timing of your choice as well. Doesn't need to be in 2020. Could be in 2021, 2023, 2027. It's up to you. Why would you consider using it, and why would you consider using it this year? So the reason why is if you want to donate, you want to give more money this year to get a tax deduction, but you're not ready, you either haven't identified who you'd want to give it to, or Let's say you want to make your next 3 years of donations to the church right now because you've got the cash flow, you got the bonus, whatever, and to give all the money to the church right now and then not give anything over the next 2 years might hurt the church's cash flow, or it might not line up with your intentions. You can give all the money this year into a donor advised fund and then disperse a chunk each year over the next 3 years to the church. So if you're willing or able to give a large amount this year, but still want to have control over the timing of when that 501c3 receives the dollars, that's why you would set up a donor advised fund. That's the big why. What about the whys for right now? This year, I've shared with you recently, there are some special rules regarding making contributions, how it can help you on your taxes. Number one, if you don't itemize, this is a year that you can get up to $300 for a single filer or $600 for married filing jointly, where you can get an above-the-line deduction for your charitable contributions. Normally, the only way those charitable contributions help you on your taxes is if you itemize. But this year alone, if you don't, you can get a $300 or $600 deduction if you make a donation. If you're not sure which organization you'd want to donate to, set up a donor advised fund, put the $300 or $600 in there, get that write-off on your taxes. Or second, the second change that's happened this year is normally there's a limit on the amount of donation that you can make and get a benefit for it on your taxes this year. It's 60% of your adjusted gross income. But through the CARES Act this year alone, you can go up to 100% of your income can be a deduction for charitable contributions. And if you're looking around saying, well, geez, I might have the resources for that, or I could do a multi-year giving strategy and make a big donation this year to make my income look really small, but I don't want to flood the organization with that cash right now. I want to space out those the 501c3 from receiving those funds. You can use a donor advised fund. Put all the money in, give you that big deduction this year, and then it's of your choice as to when you want to disperse those dollars. And the final reason why this year is we have seen an unbelievable roller coaster ride in the stock market this year. And if you've got dollars that are not in a tax sheltered account, they're in a joint account or in a trust account, and now you've got significant capital gains, and you're looking and saying, well, time to make my annual tithe contribution to the church. I'll write a check for 20 grand. Well, you're writing a check for 20 grand, and that someday you might sell those investments, those securities that have a lot of appreciation, and you're gonna have to pay tax on that growth. Instead of writing a $20,000 check or $25,000 or whatever it was, instead of making a cash donation to the church, if you've got appreciated investments, you could contribute, you could donate those appreciated investments directly from your trust account or joint account directly into your donor advised fund, okay? And then sell the investments there and disperse the cash to the church. When it's in a donor advised fund, you get a full write-off for the amount that you contributed, but by selling it, there's no capital gains. There's no capital gains there, and you can disperse the money to the church, and then you can write your cash check, instead of to the church, you can write it back into your trust account or joint account and buy new investments at the higher basis. So that's a unique tax planning strategy where you might wanna consider a donor advised fund this year. Finally, how do you set it up? How do you set it up? You can use just about any company out there. There are lots of donor advised funds out there. Some of them have certain rules that you've got to use the money to benefit a 501c3 that as long as they're not doing these sorts of things. So you want to make sure that you're searching for a donor advised fund that lines up with your overall intentions, your morals, your ethics, that sort of thing. We use Fidelity. That's where we manage a lot of money. They've got a very broad, they've got a giving fund and then a donor advised fund. But work with your certified financial planner to search what's the right giving account or donor advised fund for you, get it set up, and then here's the key point. Look at your tax opportunities, your tax planning strategies to see how best to fund that donor advised fund. Is it cash? Is it appreciated securities? Is now even the time for you? Is it the right time for you to set up a donor advised fund? So check that out. Contact your CFP who's also doing tax planning with you to figure out if it makes sense for your situation. If you don't have a CFP in your life, we've got a team of CFPs and a team of CPAs. They work together, they collaborate together. You can always contact a member of our team. Find us online, corehorn.com. That's Corehorn with a K. Wisemoneyshow.com. You can find us there as well, or give us a call, 574-247-5898. All right, there you have it. Go out and take your next wise step in your financial life.